Hands up if you've ever told a lie. Maybe you complimented someone's interesting haircut or insisted you absolutely love a rather underwhelming gift. And fair enough, who hasn't? Because most of the time, lies like these are intended to prevent rather than cause harm. But how about when lying shows up somewhere the stakes are much higher? Like a field based on the pursuit of truth. While the rigorous, evidence-driven nature of science might seem at odds with dishonesty, as many as 12% of researchers claim to know a colleague who's faked their data, which poses the question, why would a professional truth-seeker set out to deceive? To answer that, let's examine a cutting-edge field of scientific inquiry, superconductors. Regular conductors are materials that let electricity flow through them, and we use these everywhere, but they all share a drawback. You see, atoms contain a tiny amount of thermal energy, and as a result, they're always jiggling about a bit. So as electrons pass through a conductor, they pinball between its vibrating atoms in a fairly chaotic way. The result is what's known as resistance, and it's a problem because it means that some electrical energy gets converted into heat. Great inside a toaster, but most other places it's both a waste and a potential safety hazard. But superconductors represent a solution. When certain materials get cold enough, their atomic jiggling calms down, making their structure much more organized. In this state, passing electrons attract nearby atoms, which then attract more electrons, and so on. So rather than the particles behaving like a mob rampaging through a crowded room, they're more like dancers moving in perfect sync, with zero resistance. That might only sound like a small improvement, but in fact, this quantum-level choreography makes superconductors the superheroes of the materials science universe, powering technology like high-speed levitating trains and MRI scanners, and potentially holding the key to clean energy, electric planes, and ultra-efficient computers, reducing pollution and basically saving the world. But there's a catch, and that's where the lying creeps in. You see, most superconductors only work at really low temperatures, making them inconvenient and expensive. All those world-changing possibilities will only be unlocked once we can make superconductivity work at something approaching room temperature, meaning that's the goal everyone has their sights on. But while we have made progress, it's not been without setbacks, and every couple of decades, an odd pattern has repeated itself. Breakthroughs are announced, papers are published, scientists get excited, then everything falls apart. Unbelievable results turn out to be literally unbelievable, and the focus shifts from superconductors to scientific misconduct. Someone has lied. It's tempting here to imagine cartoon villains cackling over their devious schemes, but that doesn't really make sense. The point of scientific publication is for others to verify and build on your results. So why put out fraudulent work that's bound to be discovered and could end your career? One explanation is that those involved aren't evil geniuses, just fallible human beings. There's a well-known cognitive flaw psychologists call confirmation bias, the tendency to only acknowledge evidence that supports our beliefs or desires, and we're more susceptible to this when rewards are involved, like the fame and glory that comes with making a world-changing discovery. So rather than setting out to deceive others, it seems more likely these researchers began by unwittingly deceiving themselves, the first step on a slippery slope. Now, the idea that humans are fallible isn't exactly breaking news, but it does seem to jar with the way we often feel research is supposed to work. It's appealing to imagine the scientific community as being, well, a bit like a superconductor, highly organized and efficient, moving towards absolute truth without resistance. In reality, it's more like a regular conductor, messy and imperfect, with people and ideas constantly bumping into each other. But that's by design. The resistance offered by anonymous peer review, open debate, and healthy competition is the strongest safeguard we've found against biased thinking. And the evidence that it works is all around us. As these bogus breakthroughs demonstrate, though, there is still room for improvement. And ideas for what that might look like range from crowdsourcing peer review to incentivizing it, offering reviewers credit, or even cash. All options are worth considering. Because while a dodgy superconductors paper might only disappoint physicists and engineers, the consequences of misleading environmental or medical research slipping through the net are far more serious. Which means that whatever system we end up with will need to protect both the integrity of science and the safety of the public. That's a tall order, because self-deception isn't limited to a few rogue researchers. It's something we're all vulnerable to. So while we're right to be wary of being fooled by others and to build defenses against it, we should always remember the warning uttered by Nobel Prize-winning physicist Richard Feynman, that first and foremost, you must not fool yourself. And you are the easiest person to fool.